nostalgic times, and actually, I'll tell you more about that later as Bill is on the roll right now. He'll be breaking ground, and we'll see what he does. He's got the smoke on. Okay, look to the right. Look to Air Show Center as Bill. Here we go. He's gaining a little bit of energy, gaining a little bit. He pitches up. Straight up to the sky. He's going to start things right off with a loop. Immelman to the upright.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Now Bill's going to go ahead and set up. He's going to climb up to altitude. As Bill climbs, what he's doing, let me tell you what's going through his head. He's checking his aircraft out. He checked it out on the ground. He checks it out in the air. He wants to make sure his oil pressures are okay. He wants to make sure his machine is working properly. He wants to make sure his belts are tight. They actually have a ratchet system inside that aircraft that ratchets you into it. Actually, you wear the airplane. And what I mean is you put the airplane on like a glove. You are stuck to that thing, and you feel every motion, every movement that that aircraft makes. And what I talked to you about the seatbelts, he's got ratchets on either side, and he pulls on those ratchets. And I tell you what, when that aircraft is pushing G's and it's trying to throw you out the canopy, you're going to want those belts tight, you believe me, you. Okay, Bill's checking out his smoke system at this time. Gives us a couple of dots, a couple of dashes. Again, this is a good time to make sure he knows what the winds are doing. I mean, he wants to get a good look at the aerobatic zone as well. He wants to understand where that runway is. He wants to keep this aircraft right in front of you, right in the middle of the aerobatic zone.
You know, what a seasoned performer he is. He's a master CFI, designated a master CFI for aerobatics, which is an FAA designation, saying he is one of the, you know, the best of the best when it comes to teaching, isn't he?
Yeah, he sure is. Bill also, he's just put his smoke on right now. He's dipping down. He's taking a look at the crowd. He's giving us a little tip, the little tip of the hat. And you can hear that engine whine as Bill pulls to the vertical. He's experiencing about 6 to 7 times the weight of gravity, it's called a 7G pull. He pulls up, and that gets him inverted to start the inverted flat spin.
And don't worry, folks, he's not going to stay up real high for very long. He's going to get down real close to the ground here in just a minute.
Bill pushes full rudder, and he pushes the stick of the aircraft forward and opens that engine wide open. As you look right now, that engine is at full power, producing a very flat spin, giving you that corkscrew trail of smoke. Now there's only one way out of the spin, and you gotta be careful doing it. He's gotta bring the stick back to his lap. He's gotta reduce the power, and he's gotta push on the correct rudder to get out of it. At roughly 500 feet, he sees what he has to do. He initiates the exit and sets up for his next turn. He's going to be doing the Immelman. A little roll to get into that Immelman. Let's have some rock and roll. Let's have some fun, why not? As Bill pulls into the Immelman, this was first done by Max Immelman, made famous in World War II to try to get the guys off of his tail, people who were on his six. He didn't want to get shot down, and now we do it as a regular thing at air shows and in the aerobatic competitions. And there's some inside snap rolls. One wing's flying, one wing is stalled. Hey, let's push out. Let's do it the hard way. Yeah. That the force of gravity is trying to push him right out towards the ground. Okay, he pushes up into a maneuver called the necktie. In the necktie, he pushes again. And then he pulls, dives off to the left. And that forms a nice little bow tie you can see made by the smoke trail. Okay, he's going to go ahead and turn a ratchet here. Back and forth he rolls. He's showing you what knife-edge flight is all about. Knife-edge flight means you're flying on the side of your aircraft and the fuselage is producing the lift, not the wings. He pulls up again, rolls inverted. He's looking down at the ground. He wants to set things up because he wants to do a snap roll right on the down line here. Let's see. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do a pinwheel at this point.
Oh, this is about my favorite maneuver that he and Spencer do there, Dick.
All right, the pinwheel is called a hammerhead. It's a double hammerhead, and what that means is, at this point right when he reaches zero airspeed, he's going to kick the left rudder, and he's going to hold it. He's going to hold it. That. No, right, one more time.
Oh, nicely done.
That is one of the hardest maneuvers to do that can possibly... It looks easy because Bill makes it look that way, but I tell you what, it's spectacular and it is one tough one to do.
God, I love watching that. That is good stuff.
Okay, he's doing another reversal turn. This is the reverse, or this is a Cuban. He's going to roll back. Let's see how many rolls he does. He just doesn't roll level. He's got to make a 1.5 roll. Okay, as he pulls up again, that's about 7 times the force of gravity called, a 7G pull. 1, 2, 3, 4 points on the way up. Into another hammerhead. He's going to kick the left rudder. There he goes. Then come back through his own trail of smoke. He's going to line up to set up. Off to air show left. And go right into his next maneuver. This maneuver is called the Humpty Bump. Why not do some rolls on the way up? He's rolling left. The only thing that he can do is look over his left shoulder to keep aligned with the horizon. He pulls the stick back into his lap, and he caps off the top of what's called the Humpty Bump. That's a turnaround maneuver that you just saw. Now, one of the most spectacular maneuvers, he's got to roll knife edge to do it, and then push forward. A lot of rudder, that is the Lumshavak. Lumshavak, whew, that's Czechoslovakian for a headache.
I've got a headache just watching him.
That's one of the funnest maneuvers to do, let me tell you that, and it's a hard one to get just right. Okay, we're going to set up and do about a 3/4 loop here as he pulls the stick back into his lap one more time. Bill's lining up with runway 30. He's going to come back for you, keep her in the air show center. Okay, pulling up to the vertical, more point rolls on the way up. He's going to give you a little tail wag there. And that's his way of saying, I think I'm going to make this hammerhead a little bit more difficult. The hammerhead turn. Okay, I think we might see a little outside maneuvers on this one. Pushing G's, that means he pushes the aircraft, the stick of the aircraft forward, which forces him out the top of the aircraft. That's why I told you they got to really keep those belts tight. Keep them strapped to the seat. Now, this is called one of the things I call an ouch maneuver. That's a push out. Whew! That sends all the blood to your head there, doesn't it, John?
Yeah, if you're looking at that, he is on the bottom of that. That airplane was flying inverted for that push. That is just painful.
I'll tell you what. He said, I think I'll make it a little harder and do an outside barrel roll. What do you think about that? Outside barrel, it's hard enough to do a barrel roll right doing it inside. Bill does it outside. Okay, as he pushes up to another reversal turn, that's called a Cuban. Again, Bill with the 1.5 roll to upright, setting up for his next maneuver, which is called the double outside avalanche. That's a loop with 2 outside snap rolls. Let's see.
You can't just do a plane avalanche, can you?
No, there's 1. There's 2. It's almost into a Lumshavak. He comes around. Whew! I love that maneuver, let me tell you. He likes doing that too. We had breakfast this morning, and I said, are you going to do that maneuver today? And he said, I tell you what, that's one of my favorite ones. And he knows I like seeing it. Has another reversal turn. Again, a cube in the other direction at air show left. Bill comes around. He's going to push. Why not do outside? It's hard enough to do the inside snap. Bill just says, I like to do the outsides. That makes it even more of a challenge. He's going to roll up. This maneuver is made famous in 1972 by Charlie Hillard. It is the torque roll. Charlie Hillard did this to win the U.S., or correction, the world championship. There's 1, 2. He's got 3 rolls. He's backing
backwards.
It up.
He's
oh my God,
backwards.
Through the trail. That is a great, I don't think that there is a better example of a torque roll than you can see than that.
That was world class.
And I tell you, it is world class maneuver. Like I said, Charlie Hillard did it to win the world championship in 1972, and that blew the judges right away.
Well, folks, you're really getting a treat today from the great Bill Cornick, putting his Pitts S2C Big Bad Green through the paces.
That's a perfect example of a hammerhead roll right there, a hammerhead turn right there. He kicks that rudder and swaps ends on the aircraft. If you want to know how he keeps it, okay, knife edge flight. There is just a little wag to say goodbye. As he does a 4-point, 45-degree upline.
All right.
Okay,
that's really opening the show. We are rolling. It's only 10:40.
Right. I mean, I tell you, I'd love to see some high-energy aerobatics like that.
Yeah, as Bill's going to maneuver his aircraft over there to the downwind, we're going to set up for Mr. John Culver, and is flying his SNJ War Dog.
You can see Bill Cornick later today, too, in the ARC Series race. That stands for Aerobatic Racing Challenge, and that is a national race with a point system to get a winner out of the whole country. Aerobatic pilots that compete throughout the country to get it to receive the Blue Sky Challenge Cup at the end of the year. Bill will be competing in that race against Spencer Suderman. That is the Blue Sky Challenge Cup presented by Shaden Eyewear.
A quick thank you to a number of our sponsors again. We want to thank the Golden Acorn Casino for their sponsorship today.